Hello friend. Welcome to my video. In this video, I will combine three computers into one network storage device using PetaSAN. On that basis, you can combine more than one number of computers into one network storage system. You will go through the main stages: cluster planning, node installation, node deployment, and cluster building, setup CIFS service. These subnets need to be separate and do not overlap. They could still share network interfaces, so it is not required to have a separate interface for each. It is important to plan these networks prior to PetaSAN deployment. Note that much of the network settings can be changed even after cluster deployment, with the exception of the backend network, which is more complex to change. In this video, we will set up three nodes each with one interfaces, using the following configuration. Next, node installation. I use VirtualBox software to create three different computers and install them one after another. There are three main settings to perform during the installer. Network configuration, here we define the host name of the node and set up its management interface. System disk selection, here we select the disk to install the PetaSAN system. Time setup, adjusting the machine time and time zone. We need to repeat the above steps for installing the remaining nodes. On reboot, a console will be display node data as well list the URL for the deployment wizard. To deploy node 1, access the deployment wizard on port 5001 of node. In our case 10.11.32.115:5001. Since this is the first node, we need to create a new cluster. Input a name for the cluster and assign a password, this will be the root password for all cluster nodes. We leave the defaults, then click Next. Next, in the cluster network settings, we need to map our subnets to the cluster interfaces and bonds. Be careful with the backend network settings as they are not easy to change once the cluster is operational. The services subnet interfaces can be changed later from the UI in an operational cluster. Next is the cluster tuning page. Only input the expected cluster disk size range. Next, input the backend IP address of the current node being deployed, in our case 10.11.33.115. Next, in the node services page, define the roles and services the current node will serve. In our case, we assign the local storage and CIFS. Clicking Next will show that node 1 deployment has been completed. The network configuration that will be applied to a node depends on its roles and services. System disk selection, here we select the disk to install the PetaSAN system. System disk selection, here we select the disk to install the PetaSAN system. Time setup, adjusting the machine time and time zone. To deploy Node 2, access the deployment wizard on port 5001 of Node. In our case 10.11.32.116:5001. Select to join the cluster. Type in the IP address of the first node we are joining, 10.11.32.115, and the password. Enter IP for backend interface, in our case 10.11.33.116. Select local storage and CIFS as roles. Select desired OSDs as we did with Node 1. Clicking Next will show that Node 2 deployment has been completed. Network configuration, here we define the host name of the node and set up its management interface. System disk selection, here we select the disk to install the PetaSAN system. To deploy Node 3, access the deployment wizard on port 5001 of Node. In our case 10.11.32.117:5001. Select to join the cluster. Type in the IP address of the first node we are joining, 10.11.32.115, and the password. Input our backend IP, 10.11.33.117. Select local storage role and any storage disks. At the end of third node deployment, the cluster will be built. This may take time depending on the number of drives you have, leave it a good 30 minutes. On successful completion, we get a success message. Access the management UI by accessing HTTPS on any of the first three nodes. Login as user admin with initial password password. This will log you to the management web interface. From the configuration menu, choose CIFS settings. Select the public subnet for CIFS connections and range of IPs to assign to PetaSAN CIFS servers. In our case, we assign a range from 10.11.34.115 to 10.11.34.125. It is also possible to join an Active Directory domain to provide secure shares from this page. From the Manage CIFS, CIFS status page, you can view the active CIFS servers and their IPs. From the CIFS shares page, click Add CIFS share. Specify the share name to add. The new share is now created. Clients access the share via / IP address or / PetaSAN. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. All nodes starting from 4 and above join an already built cluster, the join steps are the same as before.